In recent years, AMD has been on the rise when it comes to desktop processors and graphic cards. It stepped up on the ladder, turning from a company that sold affordable processors, most of the times slower than Intel's, into one that gave us the seriously impressive Ryzen CPUs. These managed to become just as fast as Intel's processors, both in single-core performance and multi-core threading. However, although Intel struggled to keep up with AMD since Ryzen made its first appearance, the tables turned again in 2022. The 12th gen Alder Lake and the 13th gen Raptor Lake Intel Core CPUs shook the market once again, successfully competing with AMD's Zen 3 and Zen 4 Ryzen series. Both Team Red and Team Blue are now offering amazing desktop CPU lineups, so choosing one instead of the other is more difficult than ever. Which is better in the Intel versus AMD standoff? Should you buy an AMD Ryzen 7000 series or a 13th gen Intel Core? Considering that right now they're sold with notable discounts, should you keep your budget in check by choosing a Ryzen 5000 processor or a 12th gen Intel Core? Well, stay put and let's find out. As I said, both Intel and AMD have capable CPUs in their lineups, there's no question about it. However, when it comes to specs, there are some differences between them. While Intel was almost always first in technological advances in the past, with AMD overshadowing it in the last couple of years, both companies seem equally advanced today. AMD has switched to the 7-nanometer manufacturing process for Zen 3 processors and carried on even further with 5-nano and 6-nano CPUs for the Zen 4 CPUs, aka the Ryzen 7000 series. At the same time, while Intel still uses 10-nanometer for their 12th gen and 13th gen core CPUs, the company tweaked the architecture in such a way that it can match or even outmatch AMD's proposal. Zen 3 and Zen 4 architectures, used for the Ryzen 5000 and 7000 series, are composed of one or two core complex dies, aka CCDs. On the other hand, Intel's Alder Lake 12th gen core processors utilize a hybrid architecture that allowing the company to make CPUs that simultaneously include high-performance cores and power-efficient cores, similar to the smartphone chips. All that leads to a series of benefits for both AMD's Ryzen CPUs and their Intel counterparts. On one hand, because of the smaller manufacturing process, Ryzen CPUs usually have an increased density of transistors per square millimeter, just over double, generate less heat, having a lower TDP, and require less energy than similar Intel CPUs. On the other hand, Intel Core processors are able to use their high-performance cores for demanding tasks, like games for example, and their efficient cores for less demanding ones. This means that Intel processors' performance, heat and TDP can vary a lot depending on what you're doing. They can stay cool and power efficient during office work, for instance, but they can significantly increase their performance at the cost of much more power consumed and more heat created when you run intensive applications like games or video editing apps. But what about raw performance? Intel has a tradition of delivering desktop processors with incredible single-core speeds, and that's still true for the 12th gen and especially the 13th gen core lineup. Some reach and even go over 5 gig. The fastest of the bunch is the Intel Core i9-13900K, which can reach a top speed of 5.7 GHz. However, Zen 3 CPUs are not far behind, reaching similar single-core speeds and performance. Even more, all the Ryzen 7000 launched thus far, built on AMD's latest Zen 4 architecture, feature maximum turbo speeds of over 5 gig. The fastest of the bunch is the Intel Core i9-13900KS, which can reach a top speed of 6 GHz. However, Zen 3 CPUs are not far behind, reaching similar single-core speeds and performance. Even more, all the Ryzen 7000 launched thus far, built on AMD's latest Zen 4 architecture, feature maximum turbo speeds of over 5 GHz. And the most powerful of them all is the Ryzen 9-7950X, which can run at a maximum speed of 5.7 GHz, the same as a 13900K. Both the Zen 3 and the Zen 4 architectures make Ryzen 5000 and 7000 CPUs capable of delivering higher boost clocks than ever before. Ryzen 5000 CPUs promised and offered up to 20% more instructions per cycle than previous Zen 2 CPUs and a lower cache latency. And the Ryzen 7000 CPUs come with 13% IPC uplift over their predecessors and up to 30% higher single-thread performance. Intel's 12th Gen Core lineup also features a similar increase in instructions per cycle compared to the 11th gen, and the hybrid architecture delivers incredible levels of performance, more than what AMD's Ryzen 5000 processors can offer. Furthermore, the company said that its latest Raptor Lake CPUs can deliver up to 15% more single-thread performance and up to 40% more multi-thread performance compared to its previous 12th gen. Here's a table I compiled with AMD's current processor lineup, their technical specifications, and retail prices. When it comes to cache memory, the 7-nanometer lithography allows AMD to bundle more of it on its Ryzen processors than Intel can. Throughout the 5000 and 7000 lineups, we get between 8 to 64 megabytes of level 3 cache memory, and even more on the 3D special CPUs designed for gaming performance, where AMD uses 3D V-cache in amounts of 96 or 128 megabytes. In this regard, Intel is a bit behind, with both its Alder Lake and Raptor Lake CPUs getting from 12 to 36 megabytes of smart cache memory. But while AMD is better now at high-end processors, Intel is first when you look at entry-level models. Most of the Zen 3 AMD Ryzen processors, except for a couple of entry-level models, feature support for PCI Express 4.0, and all the PCI Express lanes on Zen 4 CPUs are PCI Express 5. Intel's Gen 12 and Gen 13 core processors come with support for PCI Express 5.0.2, but only for the X16 graphics port. Newer versions of PCI Express offer a whole lot more bandwidth. Intel's 12th and 13th Gen Core CPUs give you the best performance possible from present and future high-end graphic cards that are PCI Express 5 compatible. But other than that, the other PCI Express lanes are limited to version 4.0, including the ones that go to the M.2 slot where you connect your SSDs. Ryzen 5000 series lags behind with support only for PCI Express 4, meaning that you can benefit from the fastest graphics cards currently on the market, but not future ones. However, AMD's Ryzen 7000 CPUs are all in with PCI Express 5.0, with support not only for the graphics card, but also for all the other lanes that are connected to the CPU, including those which go to the M.2 slots for SSDs. Regarding memory support, on one hand, Intel's 12th Gen Core CPUs support DDR4 RAM running at 3200 MHz and DDR5 at 4800. But you'll have to choose a proper motherboard right from the start, as you can only use one type of RAM on any given motherboard. There are some designed for DDR4 and then there are others designed for DDR5. On the other hand, AMD's Ryzen 5000 processors only work with DDR4 3200, and the latest Ryzen 7000 CPUs only work with DDR5 5200 MHz. But that also means that you'll need a brand new motherboard and DDR5 memory to go along with the CPU. Take a look at the table to see what Intel's 12th and 13th Gen Core processors offer and what their prices are. And last but not least, when it comes to integrated graphics, there are both Intel Core and AMD Ryzen processors that have built-in GPUs. With Intel, it depends on the exact model of CPU you're looking at, while with AMD, it's easier. Most of the Ryzen 5000 processors don't include built-in GPUs, but all of the Ryzen 7000 CPUs have integrated graphics chips. Having this option can be handy in some computer configurations built for office work, for example. So, in this case, it comes down to personal preference whether you choose Intel or AMD. In conclusion, if you want to future-proof your computer, you'll be better prepared with a Ryzen 7000 processor, as it offers both DDR5 support and PCI Express 5.0 for both your GPU and SSDs. A 13th Gen Intel Core CPU will give you about the same benefits, except for the fact that your SSD slots will be limited to PCI Express 4. If you need to keep your budget in check, you might want to get an Intel Core processor from the 12th or 13th generation and pair it with a DDR4 motherboard. Or you could do the same with a Ryzen CPU from the 5000 series. And now let's talk dollars and cents. One of the most important questions on everyone's lips is probably which CPUs have a better price per value. For regular daily work, both AMD and Intel are excellent choices, and both entry-level and mainstream AMD Ryzen CPUs come at similar prices. However, things are not as clear when it comes to performance and high-end models. Furthermore, it gets even blurrier when you're looking at the two generations of processors each company is manufacturing today. Intel's 12th Gen Core and AMD's Ryzen 5000 are still on sale, with both companies offering major price cuts these days. If you want to build a computer for office work, you might not need or want the best of the best in terms of performance, and you might find cheap bundles with Ryzen 5000 processors. However, that's also possible with Intel's entry-level models, especially with those in the 12th generation. Furthermore, both can run on DDR4, which is more affordable than DDR5. So, in my opinion, when building office computers, the prices you can find at the moment should be a strong factor in your choice between Intel and AMD. If what you're looking for is gaming on a budget, you should probably go with a Ryzen 5000 CPU or an Intel Core from either the 12th or 13th generation. But in both cases, keep on using your old DDR4. Or buy DDR4 if you're building a new computer because it's more affordable, and motherboards that use DDR4 are also sold at lower prices than those designed for DDR5. Last but not least, if what you're looking for is top-notch performance in any workload, be it gaming, video editing, 3D applications, then you should check out higher-end CPUs and pair them with DDR5 and appropriate motherboards. Regardless of whether you'll go with Intel or AMD, be ready to spend quite a lot of money. Core i9-13900K seems to be the best beast right now, so if you need maximum brute performance, get it without hesitation. However, consider the fact that we should soon see PCI Express 5.0 solid-state drives surface on the market, and Intel's Core 13th Gen processors can only work with PCI Express 4 SSDs. If you want to future-proof your PC and be ready for what's next, you might want to go with a Ryzen 7000 series processor instead. The Ryzen 9 7950X, for instance, offers similar performance to the 13900K and also has a lower power consumption. In today's chaotic energy market, this may be an important plus. Check the comparison table if you'd like to compare the lineups of Intel and AMD equivalents. I tried to cover all the essential details of both companies' current desktop CPUs, including real-world prices from the Amazon Intel Store and Amazon AMD Store, hoping to help you make an informed decision. In my opinion, these are the essential things you should know about 2023's lineup of AMD Ryzen processors and Intel Core CPUs. Which ones do you like more and why? Regardless of where your brand loyalty sits, which company do you think makes the best desktop CPUs these days? AMD or Intel? Use the comment section below to get in touch and let me know your opinion. Oh, and while you're here, if you don't mind, please subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching and wish you all the best.